Hi team, let's continue with number 6 on the Foundations of Reading exam. I'll read it first, and then we'll break apart and look at some of the aspects of this problem, okay? Let's start by reading. It says here for number 6, which of the following first grade students has attained the highest level of phonemic awareness? A, a student who, after hearing the word hot and the sound I, can substitute I for ah to make the word hit. B, a student who can orally segment the word wonderful into wonderful. C, a student who, after hearing the words fish and fun, can identify that they both begin with the same phoneme. D, a student who can orally segment the word train into its onset and rhyme. Great question. Now we have phonemic awareness. We got to remember phonemic awareness is a part of phonological awareness. So I'm just going to make that triangle there. We remember we were saying phonological awareness, that has to do with hearing sound. So let's just write that down. Phonological awareness has to do with hearing sound. It's a sound thing. And we said before that hearing sound can be broken into three levels: the word, syllable, and phoneme level. The word being the most basic, syllable being intermediate, and phoneme being the most advanced. And that's where phonemic awareness exists. When we think of phonemic awareness, that has to do with hearing the individual sounds in a word. And this is the highest level of phonological awareness. So in this activity right here, we're looking for things on activities that involve the individual phonemes. Now these students are all doing sound activities. You can tell by the language in the questions. Look at this. The first student is hearing a word. Students in A and C are in activities where they're hearing words. That's a sound thing. Those are sound activities. Same with orally segmenting for B and D. These are also sound activities. So this one is a little bit harder than some of the others that we've seen, because some of the others that we've seen have involved print that you could cross out, or vocabulary, or other aspects of reading development. Since this is all sound, they're all sound activities that do fall under phonological awareness, makes it a little trickier. We are looking for the sound activity that's specifically phonemic awareness, having to do with the individual sounds. And in this case, it's A. Anytime we see these symbols where we have the letters italicized or the vowels italicized, this is automatically referring to a specific phoneme. So if we were looking at this and that's all we saw are these symbols, we know right away that A is an activity involving phonemes, individual phonemes. There's another way to get to A is the answer. Now let's just really quickly analyze B, D, and C. B has to do with breaking up a word on a syllable level, so it's more intermediate. C has to do with fish and fun. Well, that's fish and fun. That has to do with rhyming. Well, that falls under the word level, more basic, foundational stuff. D has to do with train. And in train, we're breaking the word up into its onset, the beginning part of the word, and its rhyme. This one right here does involve phonemic awareness, but it's not the highest level of phonemic awareness. So when we think about it, phonemic awareness has a lot of different levels. Let's think about that. Hi team, this is Chris Abraham from GOHAcademy. If you like this video, press the like button below or subscribe to our channel. This allows us to do more videos for teachers on their teacher certification exams. And if you need additional help, you can come and check out a GOHAcademy workshop or webinar or tutoring. You go to www.goacademy.com. Have a great day, everyone. Bye-bye.